The plant pictured here is a species of salvia, or sage. Now, there are a lot of species and a lot of cultivars of salvia out in the landscape, so it can range anywhere from 1 to 3 feet tall, but it usually does have a very upright, almost like a small bush growth form. It is in the mint family, so it's going to have some mint family traits. It has opposite leaf arrangement and square stems. And here you can see that not only do we have opposite leaves, but we have two new shoots with new sets of opposite leaves coming out at that same node. And that's common to see on salvia. A lot of times those opposite leaves are going to be decussate, as shown here. And there is quite a bit of variation among the leaves in different species. A lot of salvia leaves are going to be ovate, with maybe a chordate base and an acuminate apex, but this can vary. There are salvia that have elliptic leaves and more elongated leaves. Some salvia leaves are very glabrous and very rough to the feel. Some salvia leaves are hairless and scabrous, so they feel rough. Other salvia leaves are going to be quite pubescent and feel a bit softer. However, typically salvia leaves will have teeth on the margin, and they typically are reticulate. So if you look at the underside of the leaf, you can see every fine network of veins on that leaf underside. But again, be prepared for a lot of variation in shape and texture of a salvia leaf. They are all going to be opposite in leaf arrangement, though. Now, another mint family trait that they have is the inflorescences. We have terminal inflorescences with the flowers verticillate on that inflorescence. And these racemes do stick up above the leaves, so it makes it quite showy. And typically with salvia, you're going to have a tulipped calyx and a tulipped corolla. So in this picture, and for this particular species of salvia, we have a very prominent tulipped calyx. And that's what you see here. So that's going to stick around longer than the petals or the corolla, so it gives this one most of its color. And again, it has that zygomorphic symmetry, or its bilabiate. Now the corolla is what you see here, extending out of that calyx. They are both pigmented to attract pollinators. They are both tulipped. But this can vary depending on the species and cultivar of salvia. So here we've got a totally different species of salvia. You can see, though, again, we have a tulipped calyx and a tulipped corolla. In this case, the calyx is green and the corolla is the only part pigmented to attract pollinators. But this picture does show something else that's pretty uniform for salvia species. Usually, the tulipped corolla has sort of a hooded top lip, and then the bottom lip is lobed. And the number of lobes on that bottom lip varies, of course, but that is fairly typical for species of salvia, even with the broad range that exists. So here's an example of a salvia species that is quite different. If you look at the calyces of this plant, they are small. It's hard to tell, but they don't look very tulipped. And if they were, it would be very subtle. But now the corolla is tulipped. You can see again that hooded top lip and the lobed bottom lip. In addition, you can tell we've got verticillate arrangement of the flowers on the inflorescence. And you'll note here that the inflorescence as well as the stems are square on this plant. So a bit of a tricky one because of the large amount of variety within this genus, but if you remember those mint family traits, it's really going to help you with identifying salvia species or sage.